quantile regression in SPSS. Quantile regression finds the regression line that minimizes the sum of the absolute residual. It determines the median of a set of data across a distribution based on the variables within that distribution. Quantile regression is normally used when the assumptions of linear regressions are not met or to see the impact of independent variable at different thresholds of dependent variable. For example, in linear regression, we may see the mean effect of tax policy on the earnings. However, since the earnings is a widely dispersed phenomena, it is more appropriate to see the impact of tax policy on earnings based on different income threshold. And quantile regression can show that effect of magnitude at different quartile or threshold level of earnings. Let's see an example how we can perform this quantile regression using the software SPSS and how can we interpret the result. And this is the SPSS data file. Our dependent variable is the profit, and we have two independent variables. One is consumer spending, another one is the tax rate. So we want to see the impact of consumer spending and the tax rate on the profit of the firm. So in traditional linear regression model, so if we want to do this, we'll go simply to the analyze, regression, and then linear. And under the linear, we'll put the profit, that is our dependent variable. And under the independent, we'll put consumer spending and the tax rate. And if I press enter and OK, you can see the result of this regression. And we can find here that consumer spending and tax rate, the significance both of has a p-value less than 0.01. So we can say that consumer spending and tax rate has significant impact on the profit of the firm. And in terms of the coefficient, you can see that consumer spending has a positive impact. On the other hand, tax rate has a negative impact. However, this linear regression model, this does not actually say about the magnitude of the impact of this independent variable based on different profitability level of the firm. Therefore, we need to perform quantile regression to see that magnitude of the impact based on different threshold income or profit level of the firm. So how can we perform quantile regression in SPSS? So this quantile regression, this can be performed using the software SPSS, but this SPSS version should be the latest one. So the previous version of the SPSS does not have this feature. So I'm using the SPSS version 26. And in this version, if you go to the analyze and then regression, and under the regression, you can see this option here, quantile. So if you click the quantile, so this is your target or dependent variable, which is actually profit. If you have any factorial variable, you can put it there. But in terms of my two independent variables, both are continuous, so I'll put this under this covariate. So consumer spending and the tax rate, this should be under the covariate. And you need to go to the option criteria here. And by default, it is saying that this is based on the 50% threshold. So if you want to add more quartile, you can do this. So under this quantile value, so for example, I want to see at three different threshold, like 25%, 50%, that is your median, and 75% quartile. So therefore, I'll put 0.25 and add, and 0.75, then add. Or you can change this quartile like 0.10, 0.20, 0.90, so 10%, 20%, 90%, or at desired threshold level that you want to see. So now my result will show this result based on 25%, 50%, and 75% quartile level. Then press continue. And under this display option, you can select the option of the plotting. So if this selects top 50 effects, you can get the plotting based on the top 50 effects, or you can show the all effects in the model. And by default, this option is ticked. So keep this as it is now. And if you press the continue and press the OK, now I will get the result of this quantile regression along with the plotting in the spaces. So there are different way we can interpret it from this figure. So the first thing that I am interested is about whether this impact of the independent variable is significant or not. So if I see this significant impact in terms of the consumer spending and tax rate, and you can see the p-value is significant here. For the 50% threshold, it is significant, and for the 75%, it is significant. And you can see this coefficient value at different threshold. The advantage of this SPSS to show the magnitude of the impact through this parameter estimation at different quantile table. So it actually summarizes that coefficient, so you can see the result here easily. So this is the quantile 25%, 50%, and 75%. Now what is happening here? So if I looked at the consumer spending first, so you can see the coefficient increases gradually with the increase of the your quartile, and this is positive. And previously we have shown that this is actually significant. That means consumer spending, this has a significant impact on your dependent variable, that is your profit. And this positive impact of consumer spending increases as firms are getting more profitable. On the other hand, in terms of the tax rate, you can see the coefficient value, this gradually increases from 0.025 to 0.029 to 0.032. This means the magnitude of the negative impact of tax policy is maximized at higher quartile. In other words, tax policy or tax rate has high negative impact on profit of highly profitable firm. So if the firm, so we can say that if the firm is more profitable, then they are going to be affected more by the tax rate. Similarly, if the firm are more profitable, then they are going to be affected more positively by the consumer spending. Now, in terms of the plotting of this result, you can see here, this is the intercept. So my interest variable is these two independent variables, consumer spending and the tax rate. So the blue one here is the confidence interval under this quantile regression. And this dot dot, this red one is the confidence interval under the OLS regression, linear model, under the linear model. So what you can see here that when there is just a OLS model, if you can use that, we have shown the result before, you can see the mean effect graphing from this red line. Now, if I looked at the quantile regression line, so this is the black one with the dot dot dot. Now, what you can see here, although OLS is showing that the mean effect is positive, so you can see this there is a positive impact based on the upward sloping. Now, if I looked at this quantile graph, it also shows the positive impact. However, you can see here that this is the lower threshold level, this is the middle threshold level, this is the upper threshold level. And this line is more steeper than this one, right? So this means at the upper quartile, the magnitude of the impact is more compared to the lower threshold. The same one we can say in terms of the tax rate. So if you looked at here, and you can see this thing like it is gradually goes down. So the upper threshold level, the magnitude, if you see at the left side, so the magnitude is more compared to the lower threshold. And you can see this in this prediction line as well. So this is the green one, red one, and the blue one. And this is the green one, blue one, sorry, green one, red one, and the blue one. So this green line shows the 75% threshold line, red one is the 50%, and blue is the 25%. And you see the highest one is the 75%. So that means it has more magnitude of impact compared to the 50% and then 25%. Similarly, in terms of the tax rate, you can see the impact here. More impact is making in terms of the 75%, the green one, and then red one is for the 50%, and 25% is the blue one. So you can see that magnitude of the impact increases as we have more higher level of the threshold. So in this way, we can perform quantile regression in the SPSS.